Hey everyone, the prices of NVMe SSDs have come down loads in the past year, to the point that they're now often cheaper to buy than SATA SSDs. These also take up less space inside your case, they require zero cables, unlike SATA drives that need two cables, and they're much, much faster. So is there any reason to ever buy SATA drives again? Well, yes, actually, there are, especially because there's sometimes no real-world performance benefit of this, which I'll discuss a bit later on. But the first reason why people might stick to a SATA SSD is, naturally, that not all motherboards actually have M.2 slots to plug a new style SSD into. These slots started showing up on enthusiast motherboards around the time of AM4 Ryzen and Intel Z97, but naturally not everyone has a modern motherboard. Well, one released in the last 7 or 8 years, I guess. And that's enthusiast motherboards. OEM motherboards from the big PC companies often only offer the exact features that the PC builders require. If they don't sell M.2 SSDs, their custom motherboards might not have such a slot. Or they'll have space for a short M.2, like the 2242 size, which can end up costing more money than just buying a SATA SSD, because most drive manufacturers have focused on mass producing the longer and more common 2280 size drives. The second reason I wanted to cover is that NVMe drives tend to run a lot hotter than SATA SSDs. This is for three reasons. Firstly, SATA drives have a much larger surface area, so their design helps to prevent overheating. Secondly, NVMe M.2 slots are often located in slightly awkward positions on motherboards, like directly underneath the freaking GPU. So a lot of heat is always near the M.2 drive. Finally, NVMe SSDs are much faster than SATA ones, which does generate more heat, of course. Naturally, it's good that NVMe drives are quicker, but all in all, people building small form factors PCs or server-type machines like a NAS or, well, an actual server, might tend to avoid heat-generating components like an NVMe, because keeping temperatures down and also focusing on stability and longevity of all the hardware is the name of the game here. Naturally, in an enthusiast desktop build, this isn't much of a concern, though. The third reason why some people prefer SATA drives is that the price can be lower than the equivalent M.2 drive. Now, in general, prices of these have come down a lot in recent years and are often cheaper than old SSDs. However, as I covered earlier, if you're looking at a non-standard size, like a small 2242 drive, these can actually work out more expensive. Equally, if you're looking for a 8TB drive, for example, you'll probably find that there's not many well-priced NVMe options out there. This is because fitting such high-capacity storage chips onto an NVMe PCB is quite difficult and expensive, so there's less companies making such drives. At this storage level, SATA SSDs are still half the price of NVMe SSDs in most cases. So if you have big storage requirements or you simply want to install a full version of ARC, you might find the SATA SSDs work out slightly cheaper. This brings me on to my final point why SATA SSDs might not be the worst purchase ever. If you're just surfing the internet, running a few apps, and also playing PC games, there won't be any real-world performance benefit to getting an NVMe drive compared to a SATA one. Some people might disagree with me on this, but this has actually been shown in many different benchmarks, and when gaming, you'll likely only see a difference between loading screens. And even then, NVMe drives aren't massively faster. When it comes to downloading games, both types of drives will actually perform the same. And that's because people's internet speeds will likely be the bottleneck. Now, you might be saying, nah, you're wrong, my ISP gives me 800 megs of download, but a SATA drive caps out at 500 megs of write speed. But that's not actually correct. An 800 meg download speed means 800 megabits per second, which is 100 megabytes per second. That's far less than a SATA SSD actually supports. So if you have lots of games and you want a high capacity drive, a SATA SSD might actually be better. But of course, it's not a black and white decision. You can use both NVMe and SATA SSDs. What many people do is purchase an NVMe SSD for their boot drive, basically to install their operating system and their key programs on. And then they use a SATA SSD for their bigger storage requirements, like movie downloads and their game library. This can work out really well because you get the benefit of extra fast NVMe speeds for system operations, but also the higher storage capacity of SATA drives. The other option is to only use NVMe SSDs if your motherboard supports it, which at least means that you don't need to clutter the inside of your case with loads of different SATA cables. But you can then invest in a NAS to store all your other files. A NAS is actually a pretty great purchase because you can use them for loads of other purposes too, which I cover in another video. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. This tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thank you for watching.